गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। माय टॉपिक इज इंपैक्ट ऑफ कोविड-19 ऑन ओडिशा इकोनॉमी, ए थ्योरेटिकल एनालिसिस। एंड आई एम मनीष पंडा, एमबीए स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम एनआईटी हमीरपुर, हिमाचल प्रदेश। सो लेट्स हैव ए लुक इनटू माय टॉपिक। लेट्स कम टू द इंट्रोडक्शन। आज वी ऑल नो दैट कोविड-19 एमर्ज्ड इन वुहान चाइना इन सेप्टेम्बर एंड लेटर इट स्प्रेड अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। And the intermediate source of origin and transfer to humans is not known. However, the rapid human to human transfer has been confirmed widely. So we have seen it all across the world. And while talking about the India, we can say that the first case reported on 30th January at Thrissur, Kerala. And the eruption has affected the whole country in different ways. It has affected the country such as in terms of economy, in terms of other scenarios. So let's have a look into the next slide. So what is the rationale of the study? The objective of this manuscript is to recognize the existing research works on the field of impact of COVID-19 on the economy of Odisha. I have tried to describe and summarize up to what extent this pandemic has affected the economy of the state. I have tried to figure out the challenges and opportunities in front of the state government. Let's have a look into some of the methodologies. This paper will give an assessment of devastation caused by the pandemic on economic front in the state of Odisha. The benchmarks which I have followed to categorize the existing studies for review processes are, like, we have considered the data, some text, figures from the research paper, review paper, textbook, website, detailed report of various government and private organizations. And we have also taken like some sort of papers which has been published in well recognized journal across the country. I have also taken various data into consideration such as news reports, state dashboard data, data provided by the central government in various websites or in various formats. So let's have a look into the next slide, an overview of the economy of Odisha. Before understanding how much it has been devastated the Odisha economy, like the COVID-19 devastated the Odisha economy, let's have a look into the an overview of economy of Odisha. The economy of Odisha is one among the fastest growing economy in India. Consistent with 2014 and 15 economic survey, Odisha's gross state domestic product was expected to grow at 8.78%. Odisha has an agriculture based economy, like most of the people here are based on agriculture, which is in transition towards an industry and service based. So initially people are more into the agriculture, and rather it has been moved up like to the industry and service based on that agriculture products. And consistent with recent estimates, the dimension of Odisha's economy has increased by 122.27% during the last 6 years in terms of GSDP. Thereby, Odisha achieved an annual average rate of growth of 6.23% during that period. So let's have a look into the next slide. This slide gives you the data about the GSDP of Odisha in last 5 years. Like, have a look into 2016 to 2020. You can just have a look. 2016, we are having 3,92,804. All are in crores. And you can see that there is a steady growth in both the cases. From 2016 to 2017, we are having 48,000 crore growth we have seen in the GSDP. Same with the 2018, there is a slightly decrease in 2019 due to some kind of reasons, like the economic slowdown was happening at that time. But if we look into that the 2020 case, the corona year, we can see that there is a huge decrease in that time. From 521,275 to, it has been decreased up to 5,09,574 crore. So there is a huge decrease due to this COVID pandemic. So main reason behind the economic loss, that is the lockdown. So prior to the lockdown declaration on 22nd March, Government of India has declared the suspension of all passenger trains through 31st March. As on 10th April 2020, the amount of positive cases crossed 50. So you can have a look into this. And Odisha extended lockdown on to 31st May. So this is another one case, like this lockdown. Subsequently, the Prime Minister extended lockdown for the entire nation up to third May, which is understood because the second phase. You can means the initially the lockdown was for 25 days, which was about to end on 14th of April. Later, it had been extended to 3rd May. During these phases, like the districts were divided into red, orange, green, like something depending on the positive cases. So, in the next slide, we can have a look into the impact on economy. The total tax income collection has dropped by 24.11% as only 3445 crore might be collected during April and July. But we can see that it was almost near about 1000 crore more in that time in the same period in 2019. So yes, there is a huge decrease in the tax collection. Like as they have already mentioned that it is near about 25%. The GST collection in July and August through reached similar levels as was in 2019. It had a big dip in April 2020. Although the GST collection is same, like in through July August period, like that quarter, which was same in 2019, but it was seeing the downfall in the 2020 because of the lockdown and the kind of the blockage of movements. The railway freight traffic was down by 14% at 57.20 million ton of products were handled by the East Coast Railway in April July against 66.57 metric ton during the same period last. So let's have a look into the another slide. Odisha's economy that had grown at 7.1% once a year during 2012 to 13 to 2019 to 20 is predicted to witness a negative growth, which is near about up to 5% negative growth in 2020 and 21. The agriculture sector share of which the state economy like it gives up to 20%, like 21.27%, is predicted to contract by 6.54%. The industry sector contributing 36.26%, it is about to contract by 8.83%. The pandemic has led to the negative growth in the service sector also. The service sector is the highest contributor, like 42.47%. It is about to contract by 3%. So now let's look at some sort of the challenges and opportunities. Like some are the challenges in front of the state government, like the migrant influx, the huge migrant influx which happened in front of the state of Odisha. It is the biggest region. Like there are more than 5 lakh migrants migrated from the various parts of the country to state of Odisha during the lockdown period one. And the demand for job need to be increased in the state so that to make a economy in a race. And followed by, we have to find out the new MSME policy, how to give them loan, how to support them. It is one of the major things to support our people. And one more thing is that to find out the new source of revenue so that our economy will be in positive direction. And there are some opportunities also in front of the state government, like this during this distress time, we can have the PPP model, which is also called as a private public partnership model. And we can create more and more job opportunities, like we have the migrant from all across the country for different skills. Some carpenters are there, some plumbers are there. We can create more and more job opportunities based on our skills. And the transparency, like the existing government policies need to be transparent. This is the opportunity by applying them in the social security schemes, like we can make the people stay here for more and more times. The improved healthcare, which we can see the post-corona times, which one of the biggest thing in my view. So that's all about the challenges and opportunities. And now we are into the last slide. The devastating and widespread COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted the world's thriving economy in unpredictable and ambiguous terms. It's not only limited to Odisha, it's all across the country, all across the world. But it significantly indicated that the current downturn seems primarily different from recessions of the past, which has jolted the country's economy. But we must remember that this is not a recession. This is just a primary pause. This is the pause for a few months, few years. but it is not on recession and we will bounce back. Whereas the nations, conglomerates, corporations and multinationals continue to understand the magnitude of the pandemic, it is undoubtedly the need of the hour to prepare for a future that is sustainable, structurally more viable and living and for living and working. That's all from my side. Thank you very much.